Hi friends, welcome back for another episode of Manifestation Mondays. I hope everybody's having a great Monday and is ready to get into talking about manifesting. So if you've been watching my latest videos and putting that to practice, I hope that it's gone really well for you. If you've still been experiencing difficulties, I'm hoping that this video sheds light on how you might be standing in your own way when it comes to manifesting what you want into your life. A big part of manifesting our desired outcomes, if not the most important part of the process, is being in alignment. What does that even mean, being in alignment? Now, the best way for me to explain this process is, say you have a piece of furniture that you have to build. If you're looking at the instructions, in order to put all the pieces together, they have to line up with each other so that you can screw the proper screws into place and that you can build this strong foundation in order to have the final piece. The same goes for manifesting. When we're trying to manifest our desired outcome, it is so important to be in alignment with what we are wanting to manifest into our lives. Sometimes it's important to sit down, really be honest with yourself, and ask yourself if you might be unintentionally sabotaging yourself from getting what you want. A couple examples of how you might be sabotaging yourself is, say you want to make a lot of money. Now, when it comes to the desire of making more money, sometimes there can be a lot of fear surrounding this. For example, you might be afraid that if you make more money, you're going to have more responsibility. If you make more money, you're going to have to work harder. If you're wanting to manifest more money into your life, but you have a fear of responsibility, then you are not in alignment with your goal. You are actually subconsciously pushing away that desire by having that fear and giving life to that fear. The best part about recognizing these fears and being honest with yourself is you can immediately debunk it as irrational. If this is something that pertains to you and something that you struggle with, the rational thought for fear of more responsibility is, with more money, you can have more freedom, and you can have the freedom to hire somebody to do that job that you are dreading doing. From there, we've immediately debunked the fear, and you've gotten one step closer to being in alignment with what you are working towards. Now, overcoming these fears aren't going to always be as easy. When it deals with being honest and being truthful with ourselves, sometimes we'll come to the realizations that maybe things in our lives aren't what we truly want in our lives, which is why I think it's so important to be aware of the fact that you are doing something for the right reason. Sometimes when we can focus on, I want to do this because I want to make a lot of money, or if we're in something for fame, fortune, things like that, it can become really discouraging when you don't get where you want and you're not patient, instead of doing something out of the pure love of doing something. So I think that's an important factor to note also when you're trying to manifest and working on being in alignment. When I was playing golf, I wanted to be able to make a lot of money because I didn't want to be traveling on tour past 30. I wasn't happy traveling week to week, but I thought if I continued doing it, just make enough money, then I could be done with it. And what resulted out of that was week after week struggling, week after week being unhappy. And then I realized that I just wasn't in alignment. What would it have meant if I would have achieved that success? It would have meant that I would have been traveling more, and I had already decided that I didn't like traveling week to week. So while I was wanting this and wishing for it and trying to manifest it, my heart, my mind, my intentions were not aligned. So it's important to sit down, be honest with yourself, and really evaluate if you are in alignment with what it is that you're hoping for. Another perfect example is relationships. When we are trying to manifest relationships or love into our lives, it is so important to be in alignment. Are we in alignment with what it is we want, the type of love we want? Because if you want a certain kind of love in your life, or you're hoping for it, but deep down you don't resonate with that type of love, or deep down you don't want to give up your freedom, then we're going to start to see conflicting things manifesting into our lives. And this might be why you are experiencing frustration in your relationships. It's so important to sit down and think, does this relationship truly resonate with me? If things aren't going the way you want to, there's a good chance that it's because there's something not in alignment with you. So it's little things like this that we need to pinpoint address, and once we pinpoint and address it, it can become easier to start working towards taking the right steps. And as we start taking the right steps, we slowly become more and more in alignment. So I hope you guys enjoyed this quick little breakdown today, and I hope to see you guys next week. Make sure to like, subscribe, and turn on those bell notifications. So I'm really excited to share these things with you. I have a lot of fun stuff coming up in the month of August and September that I hope you guys will tune into. So make sure you like, subscribe, and leave me a comment. Let me know what you guys want to see and what you guys want to hear about. Until then, thank you guys so much for tuning in, and I will see you next time.